Hey Chad, I'm so excited that you're going to be joining our deaf education team. Our team leader asked me to give you a quick little update about our CLAIRE expressive and receptive communication continuum. Basically, this is a tool that we use to help us understand how are our students best taking in communication? Are they mostly relying on visually, are they looking for signs? Are they mostly relying on their hearing or somewhere in between? And then the same thing in terms of their expressive output. Are they mostly using signs to expressively communicate, mostly speaking, or somewhere in between, mix of both? And I have some visuals to show you in a sec. But the most important thing for us to remember is that to best serve our students, we need to know where they're at so that we can meet them there. So once we understand how our students best express themselves and how they best take in input, hopefully meaningful input, then that is how we can best serve them. So I'm going to share my screen with you really quick. Let's see here. I have a visual here. This is our receptive communication continuum. So you can see that on one end we have fully visual person, meaning that they are not using any auditory stimulus in order to take in information. They are only taking in information visually. So we would want to make sure that we are signing, fully signing very clearly with that student. We could still include mouthing, or probably better would be to use mouth morphemes, because a student that is fully relying on visual stimulus is probably going to be more on the ASL end of things, where we would be using our mouth morphemes instead of mouthing the English words. Not necessarily, though. You could have, a fully deaf individual using C, not saying that's out of the question. Then we kind of move down this continuum to the other opposite end, which would be somebody who is fully relying on hearing, with or without assistive technology, in order to take in information from others. So in the middle, we have st a student who would be equally or balanced with their receptive input. If we're working with a student who's, in the middle there, we would want to make sure that we are SIM-comming so that they're able to take in the visual stimulus as well as the audio stimulus. And then, in between, you have those levels between the two extremes in the middle. So, for example, if you have a student who's mostly auditory, you would want to emphasize the use of your voice, and you could kind of de-emphasize how much you are signing, but definitely keep an eye out to make sure that you are meeting the needs, their needs, and that they can understand you. And then same on the opposite end. If you have a student who's mostly visual, then you want to support a little bit with your speech, but just be aware that they're mostly taking in what you're signing. So I took some of our students that you'll be working with, and I placed them along this continuum. So you can see we have Derek on one end at home. His parents don't, his parents don't fully sign. And so that is his primary method of taking in information. And then we have Brianna kind of towards the other end there, where she is mostly auditory. Don't get me wrong, her signing skills are beautiful, but you might not know this about her, but she is actually picking up a lot with her ears, and doesn't need you to sign as much with her. Now, expressively is a different story, and we'll see that in a second. You'll see our sweet little sweetheart in the middle here. You notice that she's still developing her language, but she's SIM-comms essentially is what she's doing, right? She's signing, she's talking at the same time. Are they fully linked up? Not yet, but we're going to keep working with her on developing that. So that was all receptive. How is the child receiving language? Now we're going to look at the expressive communication continuum. So just like receptive, on one end we have a person who is fully committed to signing. All of their expression comes from their hands and their body and their facial expression. And then the opposite end of there, that spectrum would be someone who's fully oral. So they're will not be signing to express themselves. They're only going to be speaking. In the middle, we have our SimComer again with our balance. And then you have a person who could be mostly oral that throws in a little bit of sign there. You'd have somebody that's mostly signing with a little bit of speech thrown in. But yeah, so here are these same kiddos, and you'll notice some of them have moved places. So our same little friend is in the middle. She's SimComs at home, they're SimComing. So that's what she's taking in. And so that's a lot of what she's putting out as well. Is this balance of signing and speaking. And you'll notice that Brianna, now receptively, she is able to access a lot of speech discrimination to understand what it is that she's hearing, but she prefers to express herself mostly through sign. And I'm sure that you noticed just how fluent she is. And we, you know, definitely appreciate her skills a lot. And then we have our sweet little sweethearts on the full end of, like, we are expressing ourselves with signs, because we have so many students in our program that are all across this spectrum, both receptively and expressively. We want to make sure that we are keeping our skills both in the kind of ASL realm of things, as well as the C realm of things, kind of English-based sign systems, but also, like, brushing up on our SimCom skills and working really hard to make sure that that we're not speaking our ASL gloss. You remember that from ASL classes? You have to write all that. We want to make sure that the words coming out of our mouths are not in ASL word order. So that's something that we'll be on the lookout for. But Chad, I'm so looking forward to starting this year with you. So if you have any questions, just let me know. All right, thank you.